Game number one, ladies, and well, we are in a best of three series that will actually determine another player that qualifies for the offline final of the Endgame Gear Masters in Germany. All the way up to the top right of Amazonia, we have White and Nerdy, aka One, and down to the bottom left in our mirror match, we see Ixlaw, two German players going up against each other to attend, or hopefully attend, an event in Germany. Okay, so this is going to be a fun one. On the 17th of August, the offline finals will take place, and the top four players of the playoffs will attend the event and fight for the prize money. There's €2,500 on the line as the players clash to try and take that. I mean, actually, all of the players will get at least some prize money that attend the finals. There's also a lot of hardware from AMD and from Endgame Gear on the line. And the entire event is, by the way, also open to the public. So if you guys want to stop by, hang around, meet the players, also a few of the old legends that I invited to stop by as well, like for example Taker, Hazuops, then you're more than welcome. The entire thing is going to take place in the Esports Factory in Osnabrück. Tickets are being sold as well. And again, selling of the tickets is mainly just so that we know how many people will arrive there. I think it costs $5 to get a ticket, and in exchange for that you get a free drink. So at the end of the day, it's free entry. But it helps, obviously, to also ensure that we know how many people will go there, so that we can prepare a bit with the catering, make sure that we have enough there for the barbecue. And so, if you want to have more information, you can just head over to endgamegear-masters.com and check the page out and everything about the offline finals. So we're under an opening here on the side of White and Nerdy. Graveyard already in production for him as well. For Ixlaw also, same opening. So nobody going into a Lich first with early rush that we could potentially see in an Undead versus Undead. And this is going to be a pretty interesting setup right now, because I honestly don't really know who to favor here. We have with White and Nerdy an extremely powerful Undead player. Ixlaw obviously these days also quite strong coming back into the game. Not investing as much time, I'd say, as most others with his full-time job that he's still rocking there too. But in this case, it's all down to the wire. I mean, this is the final series for one of the two players. The other one will make it into the top four. And, well, let's see who's going to make it. It's a best of three. Once that we are attending the offline finals, we're mostly talking about best of fives. One Scout Acolyte already eliminated here. The opening directly with Fiends for Ixlaw. White Nerdy is obviously heading into the same style and gets a Spider-Man socks there immediately. As we are having also a little bit more creeping going on now for Ixlaw himself, already scouted out by White and Nerdy then again. But that rogue is going to get dropped. And we got a Cloak of Shadows. I don't really think it's going to give him too much value right now. Probably going to end up being sold here eventually. But especially during the first night, depending on the race you go up against, you might be able to get some value out of this one. We're having another coil set up, so aggro already on the kobolds here. And both of them are just like going straight in for a little bit of additional creeping. With the Death Knight of the side and White and Nerdy already hitting level 2. We're having, in terms of items, nothing extra added to the mix just yet, but the Taskmaster is going to be the center of attention of both players, as we have Ixlaw moving in with the last hit against the Skeleton. So far, so good. And White and Nerdy is actually in a bit of trouble here, because he doesn't have any fiends with his little Death Knight army. And that means that there's a very good chance that Ixlaw is going to get the experience on this one. White and Nerdy, on the other hand, has the aura already, and that gives him a slight advantage, at least on the regeneration and the movement speed. So, still the play around the Kobold Taskmaster, and now it comes down to whether or not a coil can be used here. But he's still playing around with this. Nice job here, always trying to keep vision on the Kobold Taskmaster. And there's the coil, and he gets it! Steals the experience away, nicely done, but the Circle of Nobility is still getting used by, still getting stolen by Ixlaw. So Necropolis, in the meantime, the tech is already on its way. Ixlaw is a little bit slower on this one, since he invested into the earlier fiends that he then immediately used for creeping. So White Nerdy is currently looking at an experience lead over his opponent. A small one, albeit, but still, it's there. And tries to go also into additional level 5 creeps right now for additional items. What are we gonna get? We're having Claws of Attack plus 6. And the second hero is going to be quite happy about this, as Ixlaw is still busying himself in the middle of the map to try and get additional experience and items now too. And it's a Ring of Protection plus 3 that he can ask about. So scouts are still going on for both of them. But in the main base, as you would assume, the tech into tier 3 already for White and Nerdy. Ixlot himself, as we already established earlier, slightly behind in the tech pattern, has also won Nerubian Tower. And that Nerubian Tower is missing, is completely absent in the main base of White and Nerdy. So he has the Lich a little bit quicker, he invested less into the defense, played this a little bit more greedy than his opponent. And Ixlot is still active with another quick hit. Gets a Sobi Mask! Okay, now we're talking! Great item for him! Needs to be careful that he doesn't get creepjacked here. And actually the skeleton finds out about all of this. There's the coil keeping the fiend alive. And White and Nerdy might actually be able to intercept one here. He's already starting to move down, but the Death Knight with level 3 now has enough to get coils through once again. And it comes down to a micro battle at this point. The surround attempts against one of the fiends, but also White and Nerdy is starting to fall a little bit low on his Death Knight. Needs to be careful here. Ixlot moves out of harm's way with all of his units. Has by now also the Lich in the training and the tech into the Black Citadel. But as we've seen previously, he is quite a little bit behind on that guard. So a healing potion for the Death Knight is being brought over by the Lich, and that is definitely needed. I mean, he really, really lost a lot of HP in the last encounter there. The continuous focus that we've seen from Ixlot against him was definitely a problem. 30 against 36 supply currently, and still the attempt to get more experience in this way. But for Ixlot, it's now a situation on the game where he needs to be a bit more careful, just simply because he doesn't have that Lich yet. And if you don't have a Lich and your opponent already rocks a Nova, then you are obviously in trouble when you try to keep your fiends alive. It slows you down, your opponent has an easier time to chase, so that's definitely fantastic. Lich is now out for both players. Slaughterhouse is a bit exposed here, but with Ixlot being in his main base, there's no real chance for White and Nerdy to force a cancel, which would of course been incredible for him. There's the attack again against the Death Knight, and that Death Knight being this low is going to be a continuous problem for White and Nerdy throughout all of this. I mean, just look how Ixlot is just focusing this the entire time. The Death Knight gets attacked and attacked and attacked and attacked, and Ixlot is just trying to keep him under constant pressure so that it's much, much harder for White and Nerdy to micro the rest of his units, and that there's always a threat that the Death Knight will finally be taken down. And if you lose the DK and your opponent still has his, it means that he can chase you down with the help of the aura advantage that he is going to rock here. That's exactly what he's going to try and do. Ixlot at 39 supply right now against the 33 that we see for White and Nerdy. And in the main base with the complete attack, we now also have the Orb of Corruption available for White and Nerdy, which he immediately got too. So he actually has that item advantage now as well. Plus 14 damage for him. There's a creep going on against the Grand Rock Golem, but in this case, not really working out. Third hero is also in play, and that gives us, obviously, the Dark Ranger. You want to have that silence. If you can time that silence properly, then you are in a great spot. And that shutdown against Ixlot is a bit of a nuisance. He keeps the Lich on the shop because he is about to get this Black Citadel, so he needs to get that Orb of Corruption right away, and that's exactly what we're seeing. A little bit of a fight here in the middle, and that's a Dark Ranger for Ixlot now too. At least it should be. Yep, Ixlot still has the unit over. Dark Ranger coming into play any second now for him as well. But the fight is still there, and there's the focus again on the Death Knight. Over and over again as both of the players are trying to go for it. Ixlot also with the Burrowed Fiends now. Still no Dark Ranger for the Undead player in yellow. And he's still fighting through, but that skeleton in the middle has already, I mean, it's gone. Like, it actually expired. So he has nothing in the middle that can deal with that. Here comes the scout and the immediate attack against the fiends. The silence from the Dark Ranger. Fantastic, but he's still starting to chase that Death Knight. There is a statue ready for White and Nerdy that he might be able to take down. Good coil against the Lich. And he's currently only on half a level. Massive attacks off on both sides, yeah, and the increased damage that we're seeing from the Lich of White and Nerdy is definitely helping him, but the continuous pressure against the Death Knight is a problem. He's just completely zoned out, and he's in trouble! He's in real trouble right now, and has to TP out of harm's way. Another coil just to be on the safe side, and after this engage, we have Ixlot on 44 supply against the 45 of White and Nerdy. Upgrades 0-0. And that's actually something that we see on both sides. No upgrades on that end, but losing the town portal, already a bit of a problem. Now more creeping from Ixlot. Great item with a potion of greater healing for him now as well. And obviously, we're seeing White and Nerdy trying to get some experience himself with additional items for the remainder of his heroes. Replenishment potion on his part, and a bit more creeping now on the bottom right of the map, but already spotted by the Skeleton Warrior. And this could actually lead to a creep check here. So with this said, the immediate attack against the Renegade Wizard, since he holds the item and he wants to get this as quickly as he possibly can, and finds now also, in addition to that, a Robe of the Magi, which means that we're having a bigger mana pool for the Lich and also more attack damage right now. So again, the play is there, both of the players, this time with the Dark Ranger. Already we're seeing the Lich moving towards the back, but he has that potion of greater healing that he can still use, and White and Nerdy is losing a little bit more ground. The Dark Ranger might be in trouble, but a coil should be ready. The Sobi Mask is definitely helping that Death Knight out, and he doesn't even have to use it just yet, but there we go. Also, Abominations are joining the fun so far without the Disease Cloud. That should be coming in there soon. First Abomination is also ready for White and Nerdy, and uh-oh, that's a problem. Yeah, blocked in the main base, and let's see when he actually is going to catch that, because that is a big issue. He needs to either get away here, or he needs to unsummon one of his structures, and that is a huge, huge setback now for White and Nerdy. 48 supply against 48 from both of the players here, and let's see what else we're gonna have. There comes the attack towards the left side of the map as he's trying to get even more experience right now. Actually, with the Death Knight now moving in, might not really commit to it. But, well, there's a double Rock Golems there, and those you can't coil. Yep, Renegade Golem is not going to be attacked anytime soon, as I'd say, but still, no, he's trying to go for it. Okay, he's actually risking it here. There's still Ixlord with the Skeleton, so I'm not sure if he's going to be able to get enough there. But he got the experience from at least one of the Rock Golems. And up to the top, alright, he got it out. So at least we're going to have him now with the Abomination as well. In terms of items, we have a Skull of the Beast on the side of White and Nerdy and a Potion of Lesser Invulnerability for the Death Knight, who's finally, by the way, on full HP again, so that definitely helps a lot. But also a Potion of Lesser Invulnerability for Ixlord on the Dark Ranger here for him on the third hero. Does have also a Potion of Mana for the Death Knight, which honestly seems like a little bit of overkill at first glance, since he has the Sobi Mask too. But then an undead army oftentimes lives and dies with the help of the Death Coil. Talking about items, we see a little bit more here now coming in through. But the attack against the Abomination at the front. Abomination nearly attacked there, starts to turn it around. Coils on both sides now, as we're seeing the players attempting to keep their frontline alive. But another Nova comes through against the Fiends as they're starting to get the attack in. And there's the Focus Fire once more. 50 supply against 50 for the two players. And what else are we gonna get? The aggression. Ah, there's the immediate kill against the Fiend after we've seen the reveal. And the Dark Ranger hits level 2 on the side of White and Nerdy. But of course, Ixlord already has his own Dark Ranger on level 2 as well. One attack upgrade on both sides, so they're absolutely dead even when it comes to that. Ixlord with more hit and run, buying himself some time here, as he's also attempting to take down the opponent's frontline. One Abom each is what they're using right now. Ixlord, low, the Abom down, and the Fiend safe. Great start into this from Ixlord, but at least another one falls. So White and Nerdy is able to get at least this kill in, and we're having Ixlord with a few initial Banshees now too to drop the curse here. White and Nerdy with the exact same strategy. It's a micro battle as expected, and we see both players with really nice moves here as we once again have the focus straight up onto one of the Fiends. Ixlord starting to get a bit of a lead here. 56 supply against 40. He's looking fantastic in this fight. Another Fiend falls though. White and Nerdy too late on the coil, and this is trouble now. White and Nerdy in trouble on the Dark Ranger in particular. It's attempting to move away from this, and he's on the run. Ixlord is chasing him down one unit after another. 44 supply against 56. Ixlord going for the Death Knight. Potion of Lesser Invulnerability in the inventory and just uses it barely to escape, or at least try to get away here. One more Nova and we might see another Banshee fall, but it's not quite the case. Ixlord is looking great here. Better experience right now for his army. Can continue with a creep pattern once again. Another Fiend actually spotted, and he takes it down. And we have the Lich nearly on level 3, and that Dark Ranger is only half a level away from the next level 2. White and Nerdy is in trouble. He's down in supply right now. Maybe by not as much as Ixlord would hope here, but the hero levels that we are seeing are just way better for the undead player in yellow. And at least at this point, he should get the Nova onto level 2, and that would be an absolute disaster for White and Nerdy here. Level 2 Nova in the next fight. If he has that advantage, Ixlord would have a massive leg up in the battle. And there it is. has enough mana for roughly two. That's already something. And there's the battle. Yeah, the Abomination set up to the top. And this is a fight that Ixalot is very, very happy to take. I mean, he has no qualms with that whatsoever. Taking that battle any day of the week. Ixalot 57 supply against 56 for White and Nerdy, but the item advantage that we're seeing for him now is incredible, and especially, of course, with those hero levels that we're seeing now. Just look at how much pressure that Death Knight is already exposed to. White and Nerdy is pretty much on the run at this point. There's a little bit of scouting going on at the bottom of the map as well, as Ixalot was thinking about setting another base up, but he can at least go back to that Granite Golem and try and creep that spot. Unless, of course, White and Nerdy is still playing around this. I mean, we have Anti-Magic Shell now on both sides active. We have a double Abomination at this point. In terms of upgrades for the Fiends, we're looking at plus two attack upgrades on both sides. So again, dead even when it comes to that battle. Bottom of the map, here's the expansion. Ixalot is going for it. And he's going for the battle now too. Trying to take down his opponent. 59 supply for White and Nerdy, and Ixalot is sitting at 59 as well, but the expansion is being built. The ghouls, on the other hand, they've sniffed this out a long time ago. With that skeleton running straight into the Acolyte, there was absolutely no doubt what Ixalot was up to, and White and Nerdy reacted immediately by setting the ghouls down. That gold mine not getting cancelled though, so a couple of ghouls getting sent over here as well. Another Abomination falling, and that's a problem. Still a fight around the Granite Golem, as you could see here. Ixalot losing a Banshee. And now that we have more ghouls being sent to the expansion, that should actually be a safe one for Ixalot, at least for the time being. And I think he's also producing a couple of Acolytes already. There's a next level up as we see Ixalot with a level 4 Death Knight. Another advantage over White Nerdy. And White Nerdy is again contemplating a retreat here. Ghouls are attacking. The first Acolytes are already starting to mine down here. The battle is ongoing as we have 58 supply for Ixalot. 58 for White and Nerdy, but the advantage through the expansion is just a little bit too much. The ghouls are parting ways, none falling, and the expansion is just running and running and running, with Ixalot producing additional Acolytes, as we can see here. Obviously, the Granite Golem item would be fantastic for either one of the players, including the experience. Level 3 Lich still against level 2, so level 2 Nova is going to be a big deal. Fiend down, though. Nice move by White and Nerdy. Well done here, but Ixalot counters immediately. The silence coming through again against the Death Knight. No time for a coil, but this one actually hits home. But with a Nova, White and Nerdy is still able to get the kill here. His Lich still far away from the next level. And that's a big, big problem right now. We are still seeing a huge, huge lead now for Ixalot with this little setup here. 51 supply for White and Nerdy. Destroyers in the air. Ixalot is ahead in supply. He's ahead in hero levels. And in addition to that, he has the expansion down at the bottom where the ghouls once again were trying to take down the economy. Only two Acolytes mining right now, but it is definitely going to slowly and steadily give another edge over to the yellow undead player. 58 supply in the retreat back towards his own side of the map. Still the chance, of course, to go for that Granite Golem eventually if you have a bit of a time frame where you can fight this. More Acolytes are now moving in, and this is starting to become a massive problem for White and Nerdy. He has to deal with this eventually, and rather sooner than later. And you look at these heroes, and they don't really have a lot of items. Ixalot is still relying on that greater healing potion for the Lich, the potion of lesser invulnerability on the Dark Ranger. And it's a pretty great setup for him right now. And there's the attack again. So at this point, another coil saving the Banshee's ass. Here comes the Nova against the Death Knight. Still not on level 3, but he should hit the next level in just a second. More attacks against the Fiends, and White and Nerdy is losing more and more ground here. Slightly behind in supply now too. Ixalot with another save against the Abomination, and it was focus fired by White and Nerdy, and Juan is trying to get more done, but he needs to retreat here slowly and steadily as the focus is always on his units. The Death Knight gets the potion, eats it immediately. Potion of Greater Healing already used. Another Fiend falling, and that's a 10 supply lead that we have for Ixalot now. Massively ahead at this point. Still the lead with a level 2 Nova. The Lich so far away from the next level for White and Nerdy, and that's the biggest problem that he currently has here. Rest of the army, of course, the Banshee is just doing the trick here with one curse after another. No Banshees left, and the Dark Ranger is falling too. White and Nerdy down to 48 supply. And he's on the run again as Ixalot is now under full control of that expansion. He has 66 supply and is just chasing his opponent across the map now. Fantastic setup for him. Death Knight is looking also still at that Sobi mask, has enough mana to drop at least one more coil, and there is the GG well played as White and Nerdy realizes he won't be able to come back in game number one. Great match by the two on the first map of the best of three series here at the Endgame Gear Master Playoffs. Game number two, Twisted Meadows, ladies and gentlemen. Ixlaw towards the bottom left of the map is in the lead now in this series, starting again in yellow. Really cool first game that we had between the two of them, and there was a lot of microaction there, and Ixlaw just proved to be a little bit too strong. Cross maps at this point, obviously. We have Van all the way up to the top right, White and Nerdy. Couple of great moves in the last game as well, but Ixlaw was able to edge out small advantages. Had pretty good items as well that he found there. Crept also a few more spots than his opponent, and eventually was able to set himself up with even a haunted gold mine, which honestly was really the final nail into the coffin of White and Nerdy, since one of the problems was that he attempted to take the base down, never really could finish it off, and had to realize at some point that he wasn't only falling behind in hero levels, but also wasn't able to take the expansion away, and therefore had the inferior resource income too. Bit of a problem, especially that Lich on level 3 was an issue. I mean, that level 2 Nova is, of course, an absolute beast in any kind of undead versus undead fight. Mirror matches in general are just decided by small nuances, usually a better micro and the small advantages that you can edge out there slowly and steadily. But this means also that White Nerdy has to win 2 in a row now if he wants to make it to the offline event. Again, the final parts of the playoff bracket are being played out in Germany. So this is still a best of three series, and with Ixlaw now holding the lead, this is going to be the moment where White and Nerdy has to turn it around. And that's not going to be easy by any means. So with that said, we have, once the Ziggurat is done, probably going to be a bit of Death Knight action on both sides again. Yep, there we go. First Death Knight in play. Second one also getting trained right now. Same opening. We had a slight difference in the last game where White and Nerdy specced into an early attack but had a few less units early on the map, which allowed Ixlaw to actually take the initiative after he really pressured the first hero of his opponent and therefore forced him back in a lot of these situations. And with the Death Knight being continuously low on HP, Juan had some issues in those fights. I mean, he kept the Death Knight alive, but he also had to TP out once and yield the field of battle, and that helped Ixlaw to get additional creep camps and therefore get the Lich a little bit quicker to level 3 and also level up that Dark Ranger. So for now, we're having just a Fiend already starting to aggro some of the creeps here. This could be the final map between these two. We're having obviously another series where the fourth player is going to be decided for the offline event. Spiral is facing off against Neutron afterwards, which is another insane series, to be honest with you. I mean, Spiral in general has played some fantastic games, and he was always able to pressure Foggy on more than only one map, especially when we are looking back to qualifier number one. Spiral was able to force Foggy into map number three, and Neutron might have some trouble against the strong German Orc player, but we'll see eventually how this is going to end. I mean, so far, we are actually having, on the offline event, we're having a Night Elf. We're going to see an Orc player, because Cash and Foggy are both already qualified. We're definitely going to see one Undead player, since, well, both of the players in this series are obviously Undead. And then it's just a question if we're going to get a second Orc or a second Night Elf into the Grand Final. Or into the offline finals. Gnollovers here is now attacked in terms of item, nothing just yet, but let's see what else we're going to get with this. Death Knight down at the bottom, a little bit quicker, there's already the scout. Can he also get that skeleton? Did he just steal the experience away? No. Did he? He fucking did! What? The skeleton with the last hit! Oh, this is like not really, right? But he actually just stole the experience of the Gnoll Overseer away with the last hit of the skeleton. Wow! That would piss me off big time if I was Ixlaw. Okay, so at this point he has a clause of attack +6. Ixlot is already working straight at the Forest Troll Warlord, but he can't really be too happy about this. I mean, look at the difference that we have in experience for the two here. And that comes because the big creep was stolen away by White and Nerdy. It was honestly one of these things where you just look at it and you just can't believe your eyes for a second. You're like, wait a second, did that HP bar, that experience bar just move? Did that just happen? And yes, indeed it did. Now we have level 3 already with Boots of Kel'Thalas. Well, not really the item that you want as an undead player here. It's not really an attribute that you are usually rocking. If you are a Blade Master, if you're talking about, let's say, I don't know, a Night Elf, then it's a different story. But for the Death Knight, it's not going to be too fantastic. But that's level 3 for him. Really early. Ixlot, he found the Belt of Giant Strength, so a lot more happy about that item. In comparison, at least, that is. But White and Nerdy has a lead now, and this is pretty sick. Ring of Regeneration, oh, that's a great item. If you're taking this many hits on the Death Knight at the front because you're always blocking the creeps with him, then having a Ring of Regeneration is obviously fantastic. The Belt of Giant Strength adds to that, but this is definitely going to help him quite a lot. So Death Knight now on level 3 as well, both of them nearly even in experience right now. In the main base, again, the tech into the Halls of the Dead nearly completed. And it seems like White and Nerdy is actually going to try and steal something away here. And so far, with success as well. Starting to move in straight away for a bit of a snipe, and there is nothing that Ixlot can do about this. I mean, Ixlot has absolutely no idea, but he might get the Fiend. The reinforcements obviously underway to the undead army, but this fiend is not going to make it, I'm sorry to say. Yep, that fiend is going to fall for sure. Goodbye. But the spot is taken by White and Nerdy, or is it? That's a bit of an issue. The scout is already happening with one of the skeletons, but the Death Knight should still be fine here. And as an item, as a thank you for his troubles, he gets another set of Boots of Kel'Thalas. I mean, now the game is trolling. Now the game is absolutely trolling. Double Boots of Kel'Thalas, and he's just sitting there saying, like, really? Yeah, there's the cancel on the slaughterhouse down at the bottom of the map. You're going to see the same thing quite likely. So both of them losing their tech here already. And the Lich is out, pressures the Death Knight a little bit more, but he still has to cancel this one. There's just nothing that he can do about it. Up towards the top, though, there's the portal. Ixlot is trying to get out without having to use anything. One ghoul, by the way, down. The Fiend saved so far. Can he still escape from this one? Tech into tier 3. Nearly the surround against the Death Knight. And Scratch nearly. He might just get it after all. And indeed he does. Trying to break through. Ixlot might have to use the town portal. But he also has the Ring of Regeneration. So even if he has to TP out, it wouldn't be that big of a deal for him. Because he's going to get those hit points back pretty quickly. Not having the Lich in the fight doesn't help his cause, obviously, but he has more than enough mana to keep his fiends in play. And Ixlot is now getting the Lich in too, and is trying to rejoin with the rest of the army to make that happen. So there we go. Both of them just moving back. There's the slaughterhouse built again up to the top. Let's see. Not really all that quick for White and Nerdy. So him losing the ghoul, having to reproduce a few of them, retrain them. Ixlot has started to take a slight lead once more, like he did in the previous game. So it was actually kind of insane. I mean, the first thing that happens in this series is that we're seeing the experience stolen away by a skeleton. Then we have pretty mediocre items getting dropped from the perspective of White and Nerdy compared to what we have from his opponent. At least there's a lot of armor now for the Lich. But Ixlot is now playing around the invisibility and is stealing, trying to steal something away there too. Yep, there we go. And White and Nerdy, does he realize what's happening? Seems like he might. Oh, there's the experience taken. Ixlot steals it all. Ixlot gets the last hit, and he also steals the item and has now taken the Rune Bracer. There's the surround again. Has to TP out. Town portal used for this, but again, steals the experience, which was worth quite a lot, and is able to move out afterwards without losing too much either. Death Knight on level 4. In the meantime, another item for the Lich. Oh my god, Potion of Greater Mana. Holy hell, Gauntlets of Augur Strength. Definitely much, much better items now for Ixlot, especially since he's just stole a few away. So now we're having the Rune Bracers. That in and of itself will make it a lot harder to take the heroes down, obviously. It's already trading items. We're having now plus 11 damage for Ixlot's Lich. Still on level 2, but soon 3. Death Knight is not really level 4 yet, so at least on the Death Knight we'll see an advantage for White and Nerdy. In supply, they're pretty much on the same level right now. It's not a big deal for them just yet, but let's see. We're having immediately the Death Knight here, starting to move in with the Lich on level 3. Now they can maybe start to attack a little bit. Tier 3 hasn't, well, has actually been reached by both of them right now. And Ixlord is already going straight in for the next camp. Have a bit of scouting going on by Ixlord too. Obviously on this big map you can still try and get an expansion. And this is exactly what White and Nerdy is currently trying to pull off here. Has an Acolyte already in. Oh, is he going to move away from this? Nah, that's the Necropolis. Okay, in terms of item, Potion of Invulnerability now. He's actually running out of slots on the heroes. He's running out of slots right now. Has to shift all of that over. Dark Ranger is going to come in soon, and there we go. Have it on both sides now, and she should now get those two boots of Kal'thalas, actually. That would finally boost the primary attribute from one hero. So now that we have the third hero in play, those boots are finally going to become useful. Still, shops are being fought over, and there's a lonely statue that is moving through, and he's like, wait, what? Immediately, of course, the Dust of Appearance needs that again, wants to ensure that when those fiends start to burrow, he can take them down like in the last game. And Ixlord already has the lead in this, but this expansion attempt that we're seeing from Wide and Nerdy, at this point it's only costing him money, but if Ixlord doesn't figure that out, then eventually it's going to give him a lead, obviously. Silence is already coming through with the attempted focus fire against one Crypt Fiend. We don't have any upgrades yet on either one of the heroes. 46 supply against 48. Only a small advantage. I think eventually Ixlord is definitely going to send one of those skeletons down to the bottom right to double check again if there's maybe an expansion attempt. I mean, he saw that the spot was being crept by his opponent early on in this. Lich a little bit low on mana too. The Potion of Greater Mana is in the inventory of the Death Knight. Wants to ensure that he always has a coil ready if need be. So far that's working out. I mean, obviously Dark Ritual is also part of the equation now for the Lich, which means that those skeletons are going to be sacrificed. But there we go. Necropolis is done. Haunted Gold Mine is also underway. Ixlord trying to creep again. Lich on only one side on level 3, which gives Ixlord again a lead on the heroes level, hero levels like he had in the last game. And that Skull of the Beast isn't bad either. As long as there are no destroyers in the air, this is a great tool that you can use. And on top of that, the Lion Haunt of Stormwind. Aura items in mirror matches in particular are just fantastic. Absolutely insane. Great setup. And Ixlord also moves now down. He actually should have seen this, and he actually does. Moves the Abomination away, but he can really flank in for this one, as he himself is, by the way, expanding too on the left side of the map. But this is a battle that is really disadvantageous for White Nerdy. He needs to be careful. He needs to be really careful here. Loses the first statue already, and now his Dark Ranger is getting attacked too. Another quick silence coming through to prevent the Death Coil from saving her. But there's no Nova that connects with her either. Fiend instead is getting focused, and it seems like another statue is going to be eliminated. Nice block with a Fiend. Well done. Good job by White and Nerdy, but he is again starting to look a little bit grim here. Now his expansion is quicker, so that gives him a slight lead. He's already producing the acolytes that he needs down here, but generally speaking, he is still in a bit of trouble. Ixlord now with the additional Temple of the Damned, as we've seen in the previous game, also now trying to get additional upgrades out for his fiends. Is currently sitting at a +1 attack upgrade. Gets a level 2 for the Dark Ranger, and he just has fantastic items. Double Potion of Lesser Invulnerability, Pendant of Mana, Rune Bracers, Belt of Giant Strength. I mean, just look at the mana pool of that Death Knight. That is absolutely ridiculous. That guy is sitting at 500, 600 mana at this point. That's absolutely insane. Now we're seeing the bottom of the map being grabbed, and well, at this point, we're having, in terms of setup, four White Nerdy. I mean, what else actually do we have here? Ring of Protection +5 and +4. I mean, do you want a cookie or what? But, like, that's actually, I mean, he's really not lucky when it comes to the item setup. You just compare that to what Ixlord has, and it's a very different story. A later Temple of the Damned, he's thinking about forcing a cancel, but moves away from it. One silence already coming through here, and another kill against the statue. Ixlord is sniping these one after another. Level 1 upgrades on both sides now, but both bases or both undeads are pretty much relying now on an additional base. This time no focus on the Abomination quickly enough, so that coil didn't do as much as he might have hoped for. But he still gets the kill in, and that's a level 4 Lich that we now have for him. Level 4 Lich, level 2 Dark Ranger. The levels are just way better for Ixalan. He's looking fantastic here once again. Having also the armor aura here is great in the setup. It's fantastic in the mirror, waiting for the silence to expire, but he's still saving that abomination. Great micro by Ixalan. Keeps the abom alive, doesn't even coil it. Micros is back for sure, making sure that he also doesn't lose that fiend on the other side. Towards the left, full mining now from both players with the expansions that they're running here, but Ixalan with the first few banshees in the game, which obviously means that they're going to have a bigger mana pool than what we're seeing from Ban, and also additional upgrades that are coming through. Level 3 for the Lich on the side of Van. He's an entire level behind on the Lich. Like a full level at this point. A full level. Dark Ranger is looking good. Death Knight on level 4.5. Absolutely insane setup. And Ixalan is just going for the next spot. And honestly, at this point, the question is just simply, which item is he going to find this time? I mean, honestly, what are we going to look at now? Endurance Aura? Like, what's happening for him now? Because the RNGesus has definitely been on his side in this game. That much we definitely know. So far, he's been fantastic at this part. Rope of the Magi. Holy shit. 17 on the extra damage now and 540 on the mana pool. Both of these heroes are absolutely nuts. That's insane. 66 supply for Ixalan. White and Nerdy is sitting at 54, and White and Nerdy is already down in this series. And Ixalan is going straight up for the next creep. This time he might actually get creep jacked though, because yep, there's already his opponent moving in from behind, trying to see if he can maybe exploit that situation. There's the silence, crystal ball. This time a little bit less lucky, but he can still use it for scouting on a big map. That's actually a factor that shouldn't be neglected either. But right now, what are we gonna get? There's the Tomb of Health being used too. But yeah, Ixalan is just looking great here. He's ahead in supply, he's ahead in hero levels. He has insane items and he's putting them to good use right now. There's a level 2 at least for White and Nerdy on his Dark Ranger. That might help him a little bit. But generally speaking, this is a problem. There's no Banshees on the side of White and Nerdy right now. He's going up against the Anti-Magic Shell and he just can't use anything. His Death Knight is already low. He's trying to escape here as we're seeing the focus now down onto the Fiends again. Another one falling. That's a level 3 now for the Dark Ranger on Ixalan. The TP out from Ixalan as his Death Knight gets pressured a bit too much, but he is looking at an insane setup. I mean, honestly, White and Nerdy coming back into this is going to really, really take a huge effort out of him. He just doesn't have enough. He has one Banshee with the army right now. He's down to 58 supply. Ixalan is currently rocking 67, and he is just increasing the experience lead that he has on the heroes with every single camp that he takes. As in the previous game, he has taken a massive macro advantage over his opponent. His Death Knight is nearly level 5. Just compare these hero levels for a second. I mean, he has a full level on the Lich. He has more than a full level. You just compare those two, and it's just insane. He's going to have level 5 heroes real quickly, and Ixalan is attempting to push the advantage right now by moving cross-map, has in the inventory now even more Potion of Lesser Invulnerability. He's looking at 3, one for each hero. If he snipes the Temple of the Damned now, that gives him another tech advantage that one won't be able to recover from that quickly. And he doesn't, well, he does have a Town Portal, but he doesn't use it. He doesn't have the chance to really move into the army immediately. He won't be able to save this one. The temple goes down. That's the tech down the drain, or at least part of it. And we're seeing the focus onto the Tomb of Relics right now. And White and Nerdy is sitting there and he doesn't know from where to attack. Ixalan is playing a fantastic game. Has the abomes in the back to block. And it looks like this one is going to fall. And here comes the attempt to save this base somehow. Putting Ixalan between a rock and a hard place. That's the attempt. The problem is that that is a pretty soft rock that is coming in from behind now. With AMS on every single unit, there's very little that White Nerdy can do. Another Fiend falls, and there's a level 5 finally for Ixalan's Death Knight. Guys, I mean, if Juan comes back into this, that would be an absolute incredible miracle. Right now, it seems hopeless. He's fighting an uphill battle here. 59 supply for him, 77 supply for Ixalan. Ixalan wants to go to the offline final in Germany, and it seems like he's going to be able to qualify for it right here, right now. He takes White and Nerdy apart one unit at a time, but White and Nerdy is not giving up in the slightest. He still has a couple of Banshees around and is doing what he can. The focus is on his Death Knight now, though. He might have to portal out here. The damage comes in, but he saves himself onto the Blight. Yeah, there's the Lich, still with the Potion of Lesser Invulnerability in the inventory, and the armor that he has is helping him out a bit too, but another Abomination falls! And it seems like the Focus is gonna drop another, but there's the Coil just in the last moment, as White and Erdi is saving his army for a little bit longer. Ixlot by now in 74 supply against the 55 that we see for White and Erdi. Ixlot still with the statue in the mix, as well as chasing the units down one after another. The Dark Ranger on level 3.5, and his Lich is about to hit level 5 as well. They're firing away, White and Erdi dropping down to 52 supply. It's around against the Dark Ranger, and this seems hopeless, but the portal handed over 10 hit points in, saving the Dark Ranger for another second, able to shop at the Tomb of Relics immediately, but the attack is there. White and Erdi trying to save his ass somehow. Another Abomination is falling in the Focus Fire under the Deathline. Might seal the deal here finally. He's surrounded, can't get out, and that is game. Level 5 for the Lich, and White and Erdi GG's out, and Ixlot qualifies for the offline finals of the Endgame Gear Masters. GG, and well played. Hey guys, thanks for watching today's video, and I hope that you enjoyed the match and the commentary. The remaining time of the video has been added to protect against spoilers caused by the length of the video itself. But please keep in mind, though, that this does not only mean more work for me, but also has a negative impact on the popularity of the videos and the channel because of YouTube's algorithms. It would be greatly appreciated if you'd consider supporting the channel and help me to continue the daily esports coverage by clicking the join button below the video or supporting me through the Patreon page linked in the video description. Thanks a lot for the support, and see you guys next time.